Hello everybody, in this video I will use the InfluxDB integration instead of using HTTP as the previous video to get the data from Loraserver. Okay, let's start. First of all, we have to download the InfluxDB. Okay, move to the main page. Download this. First of all, you have to copy all of this and pass to your terminal. Oh, sorry, sudo okay, it's downloading. And then after we download, we will run this command. Okay, wait a little bit. Okay. Run it to unpack it this. Okay. Now we already download the InfluxDB, so we will test with the Influx. Refill, why? Because we have to start it like the Loraserver sudo system ctl start InfluxDB and enable the InfluxDB.service to start as the Ubuntu. Enable InfluxDB DB.service. Okay, now let's check the status. Okay, the InfluxDB is run correctly. Right, okay, now we'll try with the Influx command. Influx. When you see this line, your InfluxDB setting is correct. So we have a command show database. Okay, it will show all database in your InfluxDB, but I have already some database before, so it also show it for you. But now I will use the new database. Okay, to create new database, we have create database. I will create a database whose name is Loraserver. Okay, you can put your name, your database name you want. Loraserver, now show database again. Okay, Loraserver. Now I will use Loraserver. This will access the Loraserver database. Okay, now will you show measurement. Okay, I don't have any table right here, so it doesn't show anything. Okay, now I will config the Loraserver to auto create some table in this. Okay, let it here. Move to Loraserver. Now let I check the live data. Okay, my Loraserver still receive data from Arduino. So now I will move to application, IoT app, and application configuration. Okay, try here. I have to reverse. I choose the known payload codec, but now I will choose the custom JavaScript codec functions. This session will help us decode and encode some data, and I have some code right here to decode the data. Okay, I will put the code below this video. I will explain you a little bit. First of all, I have a function to hex string. Let's see, the function will help us decode the 64 base data to hex. Okay, I call the toHexString function and transfer the parameter paste right here to receive a hex. Okay, I convert the 64 base data to hex, and then I convert hex to ASCII. Okay, and then I return. The return right here will help us create a table with the my data table, and the two ASCII right here is a parameter. Okay, this is the data I sent from the Arduino. Okay, and this is the number. Okay, it's just a number. I think we cannot receive the string to database because I have already tried. You can try it. Okay. Okay, these are two functions. The first is hex to ASCII, and the second one is 64 base to hex. Okay, and then update application. After that, we have to move integration session. Create a new one. To create InfluxDB instead of using HTTP integration. Okay, right here, I will put the HTTP. Localhost 8086 sweep right like the default link. Okay, and this is admin, and the database name right here. I create a Loraserver database, so I will put this in Loraserver. Don't put anything right here. And this, I will choose the microsecond. Okay, you can choose anything you want, but I choose the microsecond. Okay, that's the own thing, create integration. Okay, now we've moved to application and LT app, LT device, live data to waste. Okay, right here. Okay, and you see my object, and this is my data. This is the number 2. This is the data I sent from Arduino. Okay, and this is a random number. So, when you see this not known or not error, you can get the data. Okay, let's see the new one. Okay, this is 2. Okay, now I will check with the show measurement again. Show measurement. Okay, and you see right here the Loraserver auto create a device frame payload data my data table at the device uplink, but your device is in here in this table. Okay, we will select from device frame payload data my data. Okay, as you see, this is the time, this is the application name, device UI, device name, frame port, and the last one is value. This is the value I received from Arduino. Okay. Okay. Okay, that's all the config with the InfluxDB integration. In the next video, I will show you how to set up the Grafana server to display the data I receive from HTTP integration or InfluxDB integration. Okay, thanks for listening and watching.